Hello, fellow scientists. Before me, you see two common household items, vinegar and baking soda. What do we know about vinegar? Let's make some observations. It's a clear liquid. It's good on salads.
It tastes sour.
What do we know about baking soda? It's a white powder. You can use it to deodorize your carpets. Tastes bitter. It's useful in baking. That's why it's called baking soda. Now, what do you think happens if you mix vinegar and baking soda? Vinegar is an acid, acetic acid. Baking soda is a base, which is kind of the opposite of an acid. When you mix an acid and a base, something dramatic usually happens, so we'd better get prepared. I'm wearing my lab coat, putting on my safety goggles, and I'm ready. I will add the vinegar to the baking soda, and I will observe.
Observe with me.
Well, that was interesting. I saw bubbles, I heard hissing. What does that mean? Think with your brains. I think it means a gas was being released. Based on my extensive knowledge of chemistry, I know that it was carbon dioxide. You know carbon dioxide? We breathe it out every time we exhale. Like that. And that. There goes some more. If I mix vinegar and baking soda together in this bottle, I can capture the gas being released in a balloon. It may even be powerful enough to blow the balloon up. First, I'll pour a little vinegar into this bottle. Then I'll add a tablespoon of baking soda to the balloon. Stretch the balloon over the bottle and dump in the baking soda. Looky here, we have a balloon filled with carbon dioxide! What do I do with a balloon filled with carbon dioxide? I guess we could feed it to some plants so they can do photosynthesis, but we'll talk about that another day. Now listen carefully. Some people might call what we just did an experiment, but it wasn't a real experiment. This was just a demonstration. An experiment is part of the scientific method, where you ask a question about how something works, you gather as much information as you can about the subject, then you try to predict the answer to your question. That is, you make a hypothesis based on what you know, sort of like an educated guess. Then you test to see if your hypothesis was correct. That's the experiment part. For example, what if I wanted to find out how to make more gas? Do I add more vinegar, more baking soda? Do I heat it up? What's your hypothesis? Tell me below in the comments. Okay, that's all the time we have for science today. See you next time. Bye-bye.